गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू टुडे सेशन। सीएनसी, सो कंप्यूटर न्यूमेरिकल कंट्रोल, इट मे बी कंसिडर्ड टू बी अ मीन्स ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग ए मशीन थ्रू द यूज ऑफ डिस्क्रीट न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यूज फेड इनटू द मशीन वेयर द रिक्वायर्ड इनपुट टेक्निकल इंफॉर्मेशन is stored on a kind of input media such as a hard disk or CD-ROM or USB flash drive, etc. The machine follows a predetermined sequence of machining operations at the predetermined speeds necessary to produce a workpiece of the right shape and size, and thus according to completely predictable results. A different product can be produced through reprogramming, and a low quality production run of different products is justified. So we can say CNC is a computer numerical control system, is an NC system that utilizes a dedicated stored program computer to perform some or all of the basic numerical control functions. And the definition of CNC given by EIA is as follows: is a system in which actions are controlled by the direct insertion of numerical data at some point. The system must automatically interpret at least some portion of this data. In simple words, CNC system receives numerical data, interpret the data, and then control the action accordingly. So this is about CNC. Next one, turning centers, NC turning center. NC turning center is a NC machine tool which is used for machining symmetrical components. These are generally machined with two axis control, with z axis parallel to the spindle and x axis perpendicular to the spindle axis. In NC turning centers, tools are mounted in indexable turrets which can hold a many number of tools. The types of NC turning centers are horizontal machines and vertical machines. Horizontal checking turning centers have shorter beds and a single saddle with turret which accommodate tools. These type of turning centers are used for machining shorter jobs. And universal turning centers are used for both shorter jobs and for bar work. These have two turrets, each mounted on separated slides, and simultaneously two tools can be used. And an NC vertical turning center is used for machining large components. Some of these machines can also be used for milling operations. Such machines are sometimes known as turn mill centers. So machining centers, in order to perform the operations like boring, drilling, tapping, etc. on the same component, it is required to be moved through different machines, resulting more production time. The machine tools which are capable of doing all these operations without operator intervention for change of tools or CNC machining centers. Tool changing is carried out using an automatic tool changer. The typical machining center comprises of an indexable tool magazine which can store several tools. An automatic tool changer is provided to pick up the tool from the tool magazine and mount it on the spindle. The removed tool from the spindle is put back into the magazine and ATC picks up the next tool. The ATC is thus ready with the tool for next operation. So this is a CNC machining center. The types of machining centers are so horizontal spindle machining center, vertical spindle machining center, and a universal machining center. Horizontal spindle machining center has its spindle on a horizontal axis. It is used for cube shaped parts where tool access can be easily achieved on the sides of the cube. And a vertical spindle machining center is used for machining flat surfaces. These machining centers will provide it with the single spindle and automated tool changers and a multi-spindle with turret head. So this is a CNC 5-axis machining center. 5-axis means x-axis, here y-axis and z-axis, and we will have two rotational axes A and B, total 5-axis. And this machining center will contain automatic tool changer, and it contains tool magazine, and these are the automatic pallet changers. ATC automatic tool changer. And in order to perform the operations like boring, drilling, tapping, etc., the same component, it is required to be moved through different machines, resulting more production time. The machine tools which are capable of doing all these operations without operator intervention for change of tools are CNC machining centers. And tool changing is carried out in these by using automatic tool changers. So ATC, automatic tool changer, is an important part of the machining center. The ATC picks up tool from the tool magazine and keep it ready for replacing the tool in the spindle, which is presently cutting. The time for tool change varies between 3 to 7 seconds. And the ATC reduces the idle time during tool change operations. In ATC, the desired tool is collected from the magazine in one end of the special arm. At the moment of tool change, the empty end of the arm grips the tool in the spindle, removes it, indexes 180 degrees, and inserts the new tool into the spindle. And the removed tool from the spindle is put back into the tool magazine, and the ATC picks up the next tool. The ATC is therefore ready with the tool for the next operation and will wait till the current operation is over and to replace it with the tool in the spindle. So the tool magazines, the device which is used to store the tools in a machining center, is known as tool magazine. It is attached to the side of the machining center. Let me show you that picture. So this is the tool magazine. Okay. So observe this picture. It is a CNC machining center with the APC automatic pallet changer. So this is the load and unload position. So, and this is the automatic tool changer with the tool magazine. Tool magazine, it is a device which is used to store the tools in a machining center. It is attached to the side of the machining center. There are two types of tool magazines, namely drum type tool magazine and chain type tool magazine. The tool magazine is indexed to represent to present the desired tool to the ETC mechanism. The tool magazines with 16 or 24 tools are most commonly used. To select the desired tool automatically from the tool magazine and replace with the tool in the spindle, tool transfer arm is used. The arm moves between the spindle and the magazines. The replaced tool carried by the arm can be returned back to the same fixed place in the tool magazine or any convenient position in the magazine. Usually the location just vacated by the newly selected tool. So let me explain about automated tool changer once again. It is an important part of the machining center, and an ATC picks up the tool from the tool magazine and keep it ready for replacing the tool in the spindle which is presently cutting. The time for tool changes varies between 3 to 7 seconds, and the ATC reduces the idle time during tool change operations. And in this, the desired tool is collected from the magazine in one end of the special arm. At the moment of tool change, the empty end of the arm grips the tool in the spindle, removes it, indexes 180 degrees and inserts the new tool into the spindle. And the removed tool from the spindle is put back into the tool magazine, and the ATC picks up the next tool. So this is about the automatic tool changer and the tool magazine. So next one is APC, automatic pallet changer. So pallet is a movable and interchangeable part of a machine tool, which helps to transport raw or finished parts from the machine in order to reduce downtime for part loading or unloading. Types of pallet changes are manual pallet systems, automated pallet systems, and a robotic pallet system. In the manual pallet system, the operator has to physically load and unload the pallet with raw or finished part to or from the docking station located and mounted on top of the machine table. Automated pallet systems, these are normally built into the machine and operated automatically by the machine itself. In the robotic pallet system, it utilizes a robot to load and unload the pallets. The robot is often able to serve one to multiple machines. However, these are fairly costly and may not be pragmatic in cost-sensitive markets. So, types of automatic pallet changing systems. This is the automatic pallet changes. These are pallets. First one, shuttle type pallet system. A pallet with parts after completion that would leave the inside of a machine on rails. Second pallet is then pushed into the machine. The system is considered more traditional and may take a longer time for pallet exchanges to be made. Next one, swing type pallet changes. The pallet with the finished parts is lifted up together with the pallet with the raw or unfinished part. It is then rotated 180 degrees and placed onto the CNC index or rotary table. And at the same time, the first pallet is placed on the loading and unloading stations. Such a simultaneous process of hooking and unhooking pallets reduces the time needed and improves efficiency. The benefits of the automatic pallet changes are improved machine usage through the continuous machining processes. This reduces the duration for non-productive manufacturing, as the setup can be done concurrent with the operation of the machine. Simplify pallet changing to a mere push of a button or command on the CNC console. Allow for less operator-driven processes by changing pallets automatically. Allow for the unmanned operation of the machine over a long period of time. It improves the speed of changeover to a new part, completing it in a matter of seconds. And minimize manual intervention, and hence human error also minimizes. So this is about the automatic pallet changer. I'll explain about some of the applications of the CNC machines. CNC machines are widely used in the metal cutting industry and are best used to produce the following type of products. Parts with complicated contours, parts requiring close tolerances and or good repeatability, and parts that may have several engineering changes in cases where human errors could be extremely costly, and parts that are needed in a hurry, small batch lots or short production runs. And some common types of CNC machines and instruments used in industry are drilling machine, lathe or turning center, milling or machining center, turret press and punching machine, EDMs, grinding machine, laser cutting machine, water jet cutting machine, and we can say industrial robot. So, let me explain about care and maintenance of the CNC machines. The chips accumulated at the cutting zone of the CNC machine tool should be removed periodically. And since the CNC machines are under continuous automatic operation, various types of collapsible guards and covers are used to protect the elements of CNC machine tools. And to ensure the safe working conditions, the CNC machines are provided with metallic or plastic guards. CNC machines should be run with the periodical maintenance to prevent the breakdown of it during the machining. And some of the safety rules for CNC machines are never operate a CNC machine without proper training or consulting a specific operator's manual. And never attempt to program a CNC machine without proper training or consulting the specific programmer's manual for that particular machine and control type. CNC machine safety system. The built-in safety system on a CNC machine includes guards and protective devices which should be securely fitted and always kept in position while the machine is being used. And it may include emergency stop button, soundproof casing, cutting guards, guard fans, and contact mats. So, emergency stop button, it is used to shut down the machine immediately, and it is located on the control panel and at other points on the machine. Soundproof casing, reduces the noise emission generated by the operating section. Curtain walls made of PVC and designed to protect the operator from the risk of airborne chips or tool fragments. Guard fence. The fence marks the working area in which the machine moves. It protects the operator from the risk of interference with the moving parts. Contact mats. When the operator stands on the mat, the machine stops immediately, protecting the operator from moving parts of the machine. Now, some of the personal safety guidelines. Always wear safety glasses and hearing protection when operating these CNC machines. Wear the safety glasses when closely observing the cutting tools. Wear safety boots or other suitable footwear. And avoid contact with cutting edges when handling tools or changing tools by hand. Keep hands clear of moving parts during machining operations. Some of the guidelines for tooling safety are always check that machine is not operating when loading a tool magazine. Always check that the tools are in good condition, for example, sharp and free of cracks. Check that tools are set correctly. And check that the correct tool data is entered into the CNC program. Use tools within the limits specified by the manufacturer. So these are the some general safety guidelines. So driving system. The driving system is an important component of a CNC machine, as the accuracy and repeatability depend very much on the characteristics and performance of the driving system. And the driving system has to respond accurately according to the programmed instructions. And the system usually uses electric motors, although hydraulic motors are sometimes used for large machine tools. In CNC machines, large variation in cutting speed is required. The multi-chain gearboxes with the fixed speed ratios used in conventional machine tools are not suitable for CNC machine tools. Now, some of the electrical motors used in CNC drive system are AC drive, DC drive, linear induction motors, and we use stepping motors also. So DC drives, DC servo motor, is the most common type of feed motors used in CNC machines. The principle of operation is based on the rotation of an armature winding in a permanently energized magnetic field. The armature winding is connected to a commutator, which is a cylinder of insulated copper segments mounted on the shaft. DC current is passed to the commutator through carbon brushes, which are connected to the machine terminals. The change of the motor speed is by varying the armature voltage. And control of motor torque is achieved by controlling the motor's armature current. And in order to achieve the necessary dynamic behavior, it is operated in a closed loop system equipped with sensors to obtain the velocity and position feedback signals. AC servo motor. In this, the rotor is permanent magnet, while the stator is equipped with the three-phase windings. The speed of the rotor is equal to the rotational frequency of the magnetic field of the stator, which is regulated by the frequency converter. The AC motors are gradually replacing the DC servo motors. The main reason is that there is no commutator or brushes in AC servo motor. So maintenance is not much required. Furthermore, AC servos have a smaller power to weight ratio and a faster response. So in this single phase squirrel cage induction motor, it consists of a squirrel cage rotor. This being copper or aluminium bars that fit into slots in the end rings to form complete electrical circuits. There are no external electrical connections to the rotor. The basic motor consists of this rotor with the stator having a set of windings. And when an alternating current passes through the stator windings, an alternating magnetic field is produced. As a result of electromagnetic induction, EMFs are induced in the conductors of the rotor and the currents flow in the rotor. Initially, when the rotor is stationary, the forces on the current carrying conductors of the rotor in the magnetic field of the stator are such as to result in no net torque. And this motor is not self-starting. In this, the speed of rotation of the magnetic field is determined as the synchronous speed, and the rotor will never quite match this frequency of rotation, typically differing from by about 1-3%, and this difference is termed as slip. Three-phase induction motor. It is similar to the single-phase induction motor, but has a stator with three windings located 120 degrees apart, each winding being connected to one of the three lines of the supply. Because the three phases reach their maximum currents at different times, the magnetic field can be considered to rotate around the stator poles, completing one rotation in one full cycle of the current. The rotation of the field is much smoother than with the single phase motor. And the three phase motor has a great advantage over the single phase motor of being self-started. So, linear motor. So, a linear electric motor is an AC rotary motor laid out flat. The same principle used to produce torque in rotary motors is used to produce force in linear motors also. Through the electromagnetic interaction between a coil assembly and a permanent magnet assembly, the electrical energy is converted to linear mechanical energy to generate a linear motion. As the motion of the motor is linear instead of rotational, it is called as linear motor. And among different designs of linear motors, permanent magnet brushless motors demonstrate a high force density and a high maximum speed and a stable force constant. The lack of a brushed commutator assembly has the advantage of fewer maintenance, higher reliability and a better smoothness. An iron core brushless linear motor is similar to a conventional brushless rotary motor, slit axially and then roll out flat. The unrolled rotor is a stationary plate consisting of magnets tiled on an iron back plate, and the unrolled stator is a moving coil assembly consisting of coils wound around a laminated steel core. And we'll also use stepping motor. Let me explain about it. A stepping motor is a device that converts the electrical pulses into discrete mechanical rotational motions of the motor shaft. This is the simplest device that can be applied to CNC machines, since it can convert digital data into actual mechanical displacement. However, stepping motors are not commonly used in machine tools due to the following drawbacks: slow speed, low torque, low resolution, and easy to slip in case of overload. So this is about the stepping motor. Slide wise, these are the parts over which the machine tool slides move. In the normal conventional machine tools, there is a direct metal to metal contact, and since the friction machine utilization is less in this arrangement, it is sufficient for conventional machine tools. So let me explain about it once again. The slideways are the paths over which the machine tool slides move. In the conventional machine tools, there is a direct metal to metal contact, and machine utilization is less in this. This arrangement is sufficient for conventional machine tools. The demand on slideways is much more in CNC machines because of rapid movement and high machine utilization. So the following requirements to be fulfilled by the slideways used in CNC machines: as a high sliding speed, it must reduces the friction and reduce the wear, satisfy the requirements of movement of the slides, and improve the smoothness of the drive. And the types of slideways used in CNC are hydrostatic slideways, linear bearings, balls, and the surface coatings. Hydrostatic slideways. In this slideways, air or oil is pumped into the small cavities or pockets machined into the carriage or slides, which are in contact with the slideway. And the pressure is gradually reduces to the atmospheric pressure as it flows out from the pockets to the gap between the slide and the slideways. Linear bearing with balls and rollers. In a linear bearing with balls and rollers, the sliding contact between the slides and sideways is replaced with the rolling friction by the use of balls or roller bearings. And in the linear ball bush, it uses recirculating balls within a bush type of bearing. These are designed to run along precision ground shafts and offer frictionless movement. For movement along the flat plane, recirculating linear roller bearings are used. In this, continuous roller circulation allows unlimited linear movement. In this, rollers are in contact with guideways machined on the bed of the machine. The machine bed surfaces in contact with rollers have to be hardened, and this arrangement will provide smooth and easy movement. Surface coatings. The guiding surfaces of the machine are sometimes coated with polytetrafluoroethylene, or will use replaceable strips of low friction material. And when these strips wear, this can be replaced with the new strips. Lead screws are used to convert rotary motion of screw into linear motion of the slide. The lead screw with acme threads is not suitable for CNC machines due to high friction between lead screw and nut, and poor power transmission and inaccuracy due to backlash. And these problems can be overcome with the use of recirculating ball screw and nut arrangements. In this, the connection between the screw and the nut is through an endless stream of recirculating steel balls. The balls rotate between the screw and the nut. At some point, the balls are returned to the start of the thread in the nut. The rigidity and the positioning accuracy of the system is improved by using the recirculating ball screws. So, advantages of the ball screw nut assembly. As compared to conventional lead screw, the efficiency of ball screw nut assembly is very high. Reduced wear due to which it has longer life without loss of accuracy. Stick slip phenomenon is eliminated in recirculating ball screw and nut arrangement. And the power requirement for the ball screw arrangement is also less due to reduced friction. So these are the various advantages of the recirculating ball screws. So types of control systems used in CNC are open loop system and closed loop system. So this one is a open loop system and below one is the closed loop control system. Open loop systems, these have no access to the real-time data about the performance of the system, and therefore no immediate corrective action can be taken in case of system disturbance. The system is normally applied only to the case where the output is almost constant and predictable. Therefore, an open loop system is unlikely to be used to control machine tools, since the cutting force and loading of a machine tool is never a constant. The only exception is the wide cut machine, for the which some machine tool builders still prefer to use an open loop system. So, open loop system, this is the input, and this is the system. It processes the input and will give you the output. So, this is the open loop system. Now, there is no feedback in this type of system. Next one, closed loop system. In a closed loop system, feedback devices closely monitor the output, and any disturbance will be corrected in the first instance. Therefore, high system accuracy is achievable, and the system is more powerful than the open loop system and can be applied to the case where the output is subjected to frequent changes. This is a closed loop system. So closed loop system, so same thing, input, system, output, and there is a feedback. So we'll get the feedback from the different kind of sensors. So this is a closed loop system. Our feedback devices. In a closed loop system, it uses the position transducer, commonly called as feedback device. Feedback is defined as a sensing device which measures the actual position of the machine slide. And the difference between the required position and the actual position is detected by the comparator circuit, and the action is taken within the servo to minimize the difference or error. In order to have a CNC machine operating accurately, the positional values and the speed of the axis need to be constantly updated. So there are two types of feedback devices we'll use, positional feedback devices and velocity feedback devices. Positional feedback devices, there are two types of positional feedback devices, linear transducers for direct positional measurement and a rotary encoder for angular or indirect linear measurement. So encoders, we'll use two types of encoders here, absolute encoder and incremental encoder. A rotary, so this is the working of the encoder. A rotary encoder is a device mounted at the end of a motor shaft or screw to measure the angular displacement. This device cannot measure linear displacement directly, so that error may occur due to the backlash of screw and motor, etc. Generally, this error can be compensated for by the machine builder in the machine calibration process. So in this, we will use rotating disc which contain the number of slots. And one side of the disc will use light source which passes the light, and other side of the disc will use light sensor to detect the light from the light source. So there are two types of encoders we use. First one, absolute rotary encoder. So this is absolute rotary encoder. Next one, incremental encoder. So, incremental encoder is a beam of light passes through the slots and disk and is detected by a suitable light sensor. And when the disc is rotated, a pulsed output is produced by the sensor, with the number of pulses being proportional to the angle through which the disc rotates. Thus, the angular position of the disc and hence the shaft rotating it can be determined by the number of pulses produced. In practice, we'll use three concentrated tracks with the three sensors. The inner track has just one hole and is used to locate the home position of the disc. And the other two tracks have a series of equally spaced holes that go completely around the disc, but with the holes in the middle track offset from the holes in the outer track by one half the width of the hole. For example, with the 60 slots in one revolution, so we can say 360 by 60 equals 6 degrees of resolution it have. It is an absolute encoder, rotary encoder, absolute rotary encoder. This gives an output in the form of a binary number of several digits, each number representing a particular angular position. The rotating disc has three concentric circles of slots and three sensors to detect the light pulses. Typical encoders will have 10 or 12 tracks. For example, 10 tracks, so there will be 10 bits, and so the number of positions that can be detected is 2 to the power of 10. So the resolution 360 by 1024 equals 0.35 degrees. So with the resolution 0.35 degrees. And for an observed encoder with 7 tracks on its code disk, each track will give one of the bits in the binary number, and thus we have 2 to the power of 7 positions. And for 8 tracks, we'll have 2 to the power of 8 positions. So this is about the rotary, observed rotary encoder. Linear transducers. A linear transducer is a device mounted on the machine table to measure the actual displacement of the slide in such a way that backlash of screws, motors, etc. would not cause any error in the feedback data. And this device is considered to be the highest accuracy and also more expensive in comparison with other measuring devices mounted on screws or motors. The principle involved in the operation of these transducers are similar to that of rotary transducer, and these transducers measure the position of the slide directly, so they do not need high precision intermediate elements, namely screw and nut gearing. In this, we'll have a glass scales with line grating line transducer and a Faraday system, etc. Thank you.